Hello guys, and welcome to Jokkmokk in Swedish Lapland. It does not look that promising for now. It's quite grey, but according to the forecast it will be clear sky east of town later. So my plan is to prepare my gear and then drive out of town, maybe 50-60 kilometers, and find a spot for tonight and see if it will be clear. Hey, what's your name? Does not answer, not so impressed. But we can go inside and take a look how I organize my gear when I'm going out. I have also bought new boots today. Jönkängan, a small Swedish brand, which is famous for their quality and because they are very warm. Okay, here we have some of my gear. I use a hard case, plastic hard case, and inside I have some warm gloves. I have my gear packed, the guide scope, Skywatcher Evo Guide 50ED, and then I use these small plastic bags from IKEA with the cables. So this is a guide cable, and this is a cables for the EAF, and this is a cables for the camera. Leveler, I don't remember what it's called, Vattenpass, dew band, and the silicone cables. And a button of mask that a friend of mine brought in his 3D printer. Very good. Compass. And down here we have the EQ mod cable that I connect my mount to the ASI Air Pro. And batteries. So this one is the 86 ampere hour marine battery that I have in this battery box. And I also have a small battery for the dew heater. And here we have my telescope, the Skywatcher EvoStar 80ED with the focuser, CWO EAF. I also have weights here in front because it gets very, very back heavy when I have mounted the camera on. Now we are on our way, and today I got company by Rin, my girlfriend. But I think it's only because it's just -6-7 degrees today. So we are driving east of town, and west of town we have these mountain areas with high alpine peaks over 2000 meters and glaciers and so on. And east of town we have these vast areas with taiga forests and low mountains. And according to the forecast it will be clear and east of town. So we're driving 50-60 kilometers or so, and I can see the front the cloud front and the clear sky in front of us, so it looks pretty good. There were some clouds over and around Jokkmokk today. And I've not decided which object I will try to catch today. Maybe M31, the Andromeda Galaxy. I have done it twice before, but only with my Canon EOS. So I want to shoot it with my new CWO 2600 MC Pro camera too. So this is a little bit fun on this side. You can see it's a little bit cloudy. And I turn around to this side. It's a clear sky. Found a nice location. We are on a road between Jokkmokk and Messaure. So this is actually a quite good spot for putting up the gear. Not that far from Jokkmokk either. It really is a winter wonderland here. So beautiful with all these snows in the snow in the tree. There are some thin clouds, but I think it will be clear soon. Time is 4 o'clock, so now I just have to wait for about 1 hour maybe. The sun is on the way down below the horizon, so it soon will getting dark here. So this area is, I think it's like bortle 2 or something, or maybe 1. Well, I cross my thumbs, or what you say. Really hope that it will not, that I can get a few hours tonight. And I think I will shoot M31, the Andromeda Galaxy. And hope to collect 2-3 hours. But we will see soon. I'm actually quite close to the Muddus National Park, which is also part of the Laponia World Heritage. So it's a national park with very old forest and low mountains and big swamps. Now I can see Polaris. I'm
some other stars. There are some thin clouds around, but above my head it looks pretty good. So I hope, crossing my fingers and hope that there will be some shooting. Everything is very quiet here. Just hear the sound from when I'm walking here on the snow. Today it's a lazy trip. I have the car quite close to the mount. It's quite warm, around minus 10 degrees now. Have some warm glögg with dust also. And that's one of the best things actually when you are out, when it's really cold, around minus 30 degrees, and you have to struggle, then it feels. A trip like this feels very easy. Almost like a spring evening, or spring winter evening. You know, we have 8 different seasons here actually. So we have the summer, and the autumn summer, and autumn winter, midwinter, spring winter, was it 8? Maybe I forgot some, but every season has its own characteristic. So we are in the midwinter now, with its polar light. The sun never goes over the horizon from December to mid-January. And we have a period with light, but also cold weather. And then the spring winter comes in March, April, when you put your sunglasses on and when you feel the warmth from the sun. It's a lovely time. Okay, I think I will take out my tube from the car and begin to mount all cables and start to do a polar alignment soon. I think everything is connected. So up here I have the CWO ASIR Pro and a small Wi-Fi router, my guide telescope, Skywatcher, Evo guide, the EAF, and my camera, the CWO 2600 MC Pro, and my EQ6R Pro mount, and here we have my marine battery that powers everything but the dew heater band. Soon dark, I can see Cassiopeia almost above me. And to the east we have Ursa Major, the Big Dipper, Great Bear, Orion behind me. So yeah, it looks pretty good. So now I will do the polar alignment. So now it takes an image and do a plate solving. Now the axis will rotate about 60 degrees. And we'll take another image and compare them. Okay, calculated. Let's go. So now I will begin to do the adjustment on the scope. Okay, I think we are there. So this is good enough. Finish. And now I will do a manual focus first. Dube in the constellation Ursa Major. So now it's loose to the star. And here we have the star. Use focuser and bring up the focuser. Yeah, pretty good. Oh, too much. I can choose between slow and fast here. So now I do the fine tuning with the slow. So now I slew to M31. Now let's do the plate solving. Mounts loose to target position, auto-centering attempt once. Validate center or not. So target is centered. So now we will get M31 here. There we have it. So I will take some previews now, and it's not completely dark yet, but I will start to shoot soon. It does the autofocus now, and I think I will shoot 300 seconds subs at gain 100. I have to say, it got better than expected. The sky is great now. I can't see. Any clouds? Very starry sky. It will come clouds later after 10 p.m. But it's only about 6 o'clock now, so I hope that I can collect maybe 2, 3, 4 hours on data of M31. We'll check if the autofocus function is finished. Okay, first shot, and the guiding looks very good also. So I have cooled the camera to minus 20 degrees now. Okay, we got some company by our green friend, the Aurora Borealis Norrskenet, or Northern Lights. So it's quite amazing to see it, and at the same time I collect data from the Andromeda Galaxy. The Northern Lights has actually inspired many of the Nordic folklore tales, and the Vikings, they believed the Northern Lights was the armor of the Valkyries on their way to the last battle, Ragnarök, the battle of battle, where Odin would fought his last and greatest battle. And according to the Sami people and their myths, the Northern Lights were the souls of the dead. And they thought it, if you were loud when it was Northern Light, the souls could come and pick you up. So therefore they were trying to work quiet and calm during the Northern Light. And here we have my Nikon D810. Do a little time lapse with some Northern Light. And while my other camera shooting Aurora, I collect data from M31 and have to say it looks very good so far. 5 subs. Some days are better than other. Last day, the clouds rolled in after only 20 minutes. but today it actually looks good. And Orion is so beautiful also. For you, Rin.
Thank you.
Do you like to be out there?
Yes, it's very beautiful, very nice.
And this is a semla. It should not really look like this. This has been in the bag in the car. But it's bread and cream and some almond. But you should have some paper. I'm done for tonight. I collected almost about 2 hours on M31. There were some thin clouds coming in here during the last shot, so we'll see. A little bit of low contrast in the last, but it will be interesting to see when I come home, but it looks quite good actually. And there's a little bit of frost on the gear, but not so much. So we are in the car, heading back to Jokkmokk. I managed to collect 2 hours on M31, so I'm quite satisfied. Then there were some faint aurora activity high in the sky, and there came some clouds also. So, but it feels a little bit like a revenge since the last time when I was out and trying to catch M45. That's good. And we also had a very beautiful northern lights earlier that played around on the sky.